back to collective bargaining, because I don't know what it's agreed before employment for the child.
My name is Muriel, and I'm a trainer and facilitator running workshops for DIEH here in Denmark. I'd like to take a few minutes of your time to tell you about the Buying Responsibly half-day workshop we are holding here in Copenhagen. Having trained more than 5,000 buyers over the last 10 years, as well as experiencing several years as a buyer in a large UK retailer, I have understood the pressures that buyers face. But I've also come to understand that buyers too want to make a difference, and often their own personal values agree with the values that their ethical trade team work hard to implement. Over the last 15 years, customers have come to expect that companies selling goods will take steps to ensure that their purchasing of those goods has a positive effect on the lives of producers, especially in poorer countries, and that through responsible purchasing practices, people can be gradually lifted out of poverty. There can be no doubt that trade is better than aid, and global purchasing figures show that millions of jobs have been created, especially for women workers, who now make up between 60 and 90% of the labour force in manufacturing and fresh produce supply chains. With thousands of producers around the world, this aspect of sourcing can no longer rely on a few ethical trade specialists, but rather the huge scope of the work will benefit from all buying personnel integrating ethical purchasing into their day job. In my experience, this is best done with knowledge and an appreciation of how buying practices can positively or negatively affect the lives of workers. I invite you, therefore, to sign up for the workshop to see how you personally can improve the life of production workers in your supply chain, and thus get the personal satisfaction of knowing that you have done all that you can to support them rather than exploit. Thank you for listening, and I look forward to welcoming you.
In the room, the government official, because Marks and Spencer's orders were really important to Morocco at that time. We were probably the biggest single customer for Morocco, and about 10 factories were working for M&S. And he came...